All right, guys, so today I'm gonna get in the skid real quick. We are going to use the Typhoon, which we just put a new motor on. I'll explain why in a little bit. And we are going to remulch and mulch up some wood with this thing, which in total honesty is not really designed to do this. That's not how they designed it or why they designed it, but it works for it. If they would, if a Terra would just make some few modifications, this thing would be super, super, super impressive. I think I have seen various of the masticating heads for different skids like the Bobcat and things run, and I actually think this is better than most of those. So let's look at what's going on. Okay, so this is a good example of what we started with and what's left. We have that pile over there that's half done. We have this pile here. You can see some big wood in it and things over on this side. That one there is about 5 inches. That one there is about 13 or 14 inches in diameter. And this thing will mulch all of that. These big pieces over here, I don't want to mulch. I want to keep those. So I'm not going to do that. But it starts out with a pile very similar to this. I mean, a lot of this was bigger brush when we started. And then it turns it into this. And this is just like an initial shredding and mulching and then a remulch without the front guard. We'll put the front guard on it and remulch it again later and show you what that looks like. All right, so we're gonna get this thing lifted up. This is a Lexan door, because that's what you definitely want. As you can tell, this thing is violent. So you wanna do that when you're running this thing. And I am going to run over here. And I'm gonna it's gonna be a little slower than normal because I've got to run this thing one-handed, and you really need both hands to do it well. But I will show you guys how this thing handles and what it can do. So if you can see in front, there's the wood that we're about to mulch. So here we go. Going over to these chunks of wood. Now we're gonna drop this down on them. Then we're gonna run backwards. And there it goes. Those pieces of wood are gone. It's pretty awesome, honestly. And same thing over here. A couple of chunks of branch material. Put it down. You can put it down into the ground like that, and it remulches. And there go those pieces of wood. And sometimes you have to go over a couple of times, depending on the size, but yeah. That's how this thing goes. Can't put the camera outside because it will knock this thing over. This thing shoots stuff well into the 300 or 400 foot range. And at that point, you guys can see. All right, so you can see that piece of wood up there on the ground. We're about to do all three of those. Here we go. Yeah, this is slow without having hands to do both at the same time, but gives you an idea. So, as you can see, it blows material everywhere. But it will shred that down. Look, that's all that's left of that little thing now. And if I come over here, here we go again. Sorry, one-handed, this is tough, but it works. Yep, can definitely be mulching up a bunch of stuff with this thing. And I know they'd say it's not designed for this, but I tell you, if a Terra would just make a few adjustments and take a couple of my suggestions, I think this thing could be way better. And I think it would be my favorite mulching device on the market. Not just mine, but a friend of mine's as well. We both like this better than what else we've seen on the market. I don't know why, it just works better. So there we go with this. Mulching up this big old dry dead piece of wood. I don't even know what it is. Maybe elm or willow, I can't tell. It's so dry, I didn't even look at it before I started. But yeah, it's just going through this stuff like crazy. Look at that, whoa. Like any of these mulching devices, it will bog it down. So you have to give it some time to rebuild. I'm running very dull blades at the same time. These are way like ready to be changed. We just got the hydraulic motor, the new one on it yesterday. So I decided to go ahead and run it as it is because I'm impatient. But yeah, this thing is, it's super impressive without a doubt. And it does throw debris everywhere. All right, so here's that one pile that we had earlier, right here. And right here is where that other pile was, and it is fully gone. And that took, oh, I don't know, 15 minutes to do everything. And that's digging through and getting the big stuff out of there. And this is what it turns into with the Atera. I can chase down these bigger chunks like that and get rid of those as well if I want and whatnot. And I mean, there are some bigger pieces that you have to chase down from time to time like this, which is, you know, kind of long, but overall it's really small. And if I had fresh blades on that thing, it'd be way better. These things are so, so dull. I just need to get the other blades on there, and then I'll show you guys what it cuts like as well.